Comments auto-reply is hands down the coolest and most popular feature in Chatfuel. It's right up there with whoever invented sliced bread. Anyway, we've got a lot to cover, so let's cut to the chase. So if you're brand new to Chatfuel, you're probably asking, well, Andrew, what the heck is Comments Auto-Reply exactly? It's very simple. As the name suggests, it lets your chatbot automatically reply to users who comment on your Facebook posts. And there's two ways to do this. The chatbot can either respond publicly to that user's comment, or message them privately through Messenger, or, plot twist, you can do both. And one more question here before we jump into the tutorial itself, and that is, what are some practical business use cases for this comments auto-reply feature? Personally, I break it down into three, the first of which is automating FAQs. So let's say you're getting asked on your Facebook page the same repetitive questions over and over again. It's taking up a lot of your time. You have to do it manually. With comments auto-reply, your chatbot can instantly answer those users. The second use case is generating leads. So if you already have a highly engaged audience on your page, they're commenting on your posts, you can actually convert those comments into customers. And then third and finally, you can use Comments Auto-Reply to manage your reputation, your brand reputation. So your chatbot can automatically detect negative sentiment on your posts or specific keywords and then respond accordingly immediately to defend your brand. So that being said, now let's dive into Flow Builder for the tutorial. Okay, so here we are in Flow Builder. As you can see, I have a completely blank canvas. I've just created a new flow. And to use the Comments Auto-Reply feature, I'm going to double click on the canvas and under entry points, choose, you guessed it, Comments Auto-Reply. Now, in case you don't know, an entry point is just a source of traffic in your chatbot. It's how users are entering the chat experience. So in this case, they're leaving a comment on a Facebook page post and you are driving them into that chat experience. Now at the top of the entry point here, you'll see this dropdown with two options. So you can choose to respond to people who comment on any, meaning all of your Facebook page posts, or specific posts. So really, the use cases here for all page posts would be if you want to automate your FAQs or you want to manage your reputation, right? Because in that case, no matter where a user is leaving a comment, you want to instantly respond with that answer or that defense for your brand. On the other hand, if you're using more of the lead generation use case, then I would advise you use specific posts, because in that case, maybe you're doing a contest or a giveaway and you only want to respond to people in that specific context on that specific post. So I'm going to jump into specific posts. Let's say we want to go that route for, let's say, lead gen. And then I can click add posts. And here's where you'll actually select the posts that you want to monitor, that you want to have your chatbot respond to. So as you can see in this first tab here, I can see all the posts on my page. In the second tab, these are posts that are just published. Specifically, they're publicly visible. And then you have scheduled. So obviously these are posts that are not yet published, but they are kind of in the works behind the scenes. And then finally, you have post URL where you can just copy and paste a Facebook post URL that you'd like to have the bot monitor and respond to comments on. Now, let's say under all posts that you have a page with, you know, thousands and thousands of posts. If that's the case, and you want to find a specific post very, very quickly without having to scroll through all of them, obviously you can use this search bar at the top and you could type in something like olive oil, select that post, and you're good to go. Now, one final thing to mention here before we move on, if you do for whatever reason want to paste in a link to a Facebook page post here, make sure that it is from the same Facebook page that your chatbot is connected to. So in other words, if you're McDonald's, you can't put in Burger King's Facebook page post URL here and have your McDonald's bot respond to Burger King's customers. Obviously, it doesn't work that way. Sorry, but I don't make the rules. All right, so we just looked at how to choose either a specific post or a number of posts to use with Comments Auto-Reply. But let's say in our case, we are an e-commerce shop that sells aromatherapy, soaps, and shampoos. And our goal is to automate those FAQs, those repetitive questions that we're getting over and over again. And so in our case, we don't really care about just responding to people who comment on specific posts. We want to say, hey, anybody who has a question on any of our posts, we want to answer them instantly. So to do that, we're going to jump back into the comments autoreply entry point and switch this from specific posts to all posts, right? That'll help us achieve our goal. And then below that, we're going to add a keyword group for a specific question that a user might have. And within that question, obviously, they can ask it in a number of ways. So we're going to train the bot with those keywords down here. So for the first question, let's say that prospective customers might want to know if there are toxic chemicals or harmful ingredients in our products. So here we can type something like sulfates and parabens, potential ingredients or chemicals that might be in those products that our customers are concerned about. And then below that, maybe they have another question, such as, do you have any deals, discounts, coupons, that kind of thing. So down here, I'm going to type in deals and discounts. Now, as a best practice here, it's very important to note that I've just typed in single words, or I could also type in short phrases, but you want all of this to be succinct. You don't want to type out anything that's super long form or lengthy, because then Chatfuel will not be able to pick up what that user's actual intention is. So in other words, you don't want to write in here something like, how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? All right, ladies and gentlemen. So here comes the fun part of actually crafting your response to the user. As a recap here, we've created these two groups of keywords, sulfates and parabens, and deals and discounts. Obviously, each of those is associated with a question that the user might ask. So how do we connect this to a response? I'm going to focus right now just on this first group because I don't want to overwhelm you all at once. And we're going to click on this connector right here, appropriately named, drag it up, and we'll see this list of options for different customization. Now, to start, again, don't want to overwhelm you, so I'm going to deselect this private reply in Messenger option, and we'll focus just on the public reply. So what this means is a user comments that keyword on our post, and then we are going to publicly respond in the form of a comment from our Facebook page. Now, some customization options here that are worth looking at. The first of which is delay. Highly recommend you just keep this on none. You can set a delay for, you know, seconds, minutes, hours, days, etc. But my philosophy is, why complicate things? Like, if a user's already there, they want an answer, just give it to them right away. So delay, I would keep the default. Now, for the reply here, I'm going to paste in a reply that I've already typed out. And this is really cool, right? Because you see here, the first name field is surrounded in these two curly braces, these brackets, and that is something called a user attribute. This allows us to use the user's profile information on Facebook to personalize our response. So the two that you can use are first name and last name, and you can either add them here by clicking on this attribute button with first name or last name, or as you see here, you can manually type them out with those two curly braces and then typing out first name or last name. So this is really cool because, again, it's an added layer of personalization. Now, one other thing that you can do here if you want is click this add random reply option, and this will allow you to create a number of different responses, different variations, so it keeps things fresh, kind of like homegrown catnip, right? I don't know, you can tell that I write my own jokes. But again, if you seriously do want to vary up your responses, make them look more human, you can do that by adding in those variations right here. But I'm going to keep it simple and just leave it on one. So that being said, we're going to test this in the wild. But before we do, I'm going to delete these keywords here in this other group and toggle on the entry point. And now we can go take a look. And here we go. We're on the Facebook page that our chatbot is connected to. So I'm going to comment one of our keywords on this post right here. So I'll click comment and type in something like parabens. Once I do, it'll take a second here. I will refresh this post. And there we go, right? I get that response from the page, just like we set up in the comments autoreply rule. So somebody get your phone and call Chris Angel or Penn and Teller, because this is magic. Okay, so we were just looking at the first half of the comments autoreply feature, which is the public reply. And now, yes, you guessed it, we're going to talk about the second half, which is the private reply. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to focus on the second group of keywords that we've created here, deals and discounts. And just like before, I'll drag this connector down to open up the customization panel. And once I do, I'm going to deselect the public reply option here. Obviously, in reality, yes, you can use the public reply and the private reply simultaneously. I'm just deselecting it for now for simplicity of demonstration. Now, once you do that, you see the same customization option here for a delay that you saw with the public reply. The difference here with the delay, although I still do not recommend using it, just send a response instantly, but if for whatever reason you do want to use the delay, keep in mind that with the private reply, the maximum time you can use is 7 days. So that is different. With the public reply, it can be an unlimited amount of time. Now, then the next thing you'll notice, and this is a big difference, is the media that you can use to respond with. With the public reply, you can only respond with text. With the private reply here, you can respond with more rich and interactive elements and media. So when you're using this response, when you're setting up your response here, make sure that you're using either text and buttons or the gallery. And I'll explain why that's the case in a second. Technically, yes, you can use an image, a video, or audio, but I do not recommend that because it's going to create more friction for your user if you want to increase the number of people actually opting into your chatbot and becoming subscribers so you can retarget later. But again, I'll cover that in a second here. So in this case, let's choose text and buttons. And in this case, since users are asking about deals and discounts, we're going to provide some relevant response here in Messenger. So let's type something like, our current offer is 15% off, right? And then we can create a button here that says something like claim offer and connect this to an actual response in Chatfuel, where we will paste in a response that I've already created, which is your code is save on suds. So this setup is key here, right? Basically, we have the user commenting on the post. Once they comment, we're sending them this message privately in Messenger. And then once they click on this button here, they're becoming a subscriber, they're becoming a user in Chatfuel who we can actually retarget. So very important to note here that we've given them this discount after they click on the button here. And this is super important. And it's also why I recommend only using the text and buttons or the gallery card, because these elements have buttons built in. So once the user clicks that button, they become a subscriber. If you use elements like an image, video, or audio clip, with those, there's no button for the user to easily click and frictionlessly opt in. Instead, to actually opt in to become a subscriber, they'd need to manually respond, and it just creates an unnecessary barrier, right? So at the end of the day, if you want to grow your Messenger list, make sure to use these text and buttons or the gallery element so that users can easily opt in, and then once they do, you give them that discount code, right? So you're providing some sort of incentive for them to click through. That way you can grow your list and your business. Cool, so now that we've set up that deals and discounts workflow in Chatfuel, let's go test it in the wild from the user perspective. So here we are on the Facebook page. I'm going to comment on this post and say something like discounts. And once I do, I'll get a message here in response. There we go, I got the notification. Click to open it. And here's that intermediary message, right? So once I respond to this message, either by clicking the button, which is most convenient, or manually responding through text, then I will become a subscriber and we can retarget that customer. So I'll click claim offer as the user. There we go, I get my discount code and I've also been added to their Messenger list. Now, in the words of the late great Steve Jobs, we have one more thing, and that relates to the private reply that we were just setting up. So you may have noticed at the bottom here, this mysterious save user input field. And what this is really an alternative to using the button that we were just talking about. So make no mistake, the button still by far is the easiest, the most frictionless way for users to opt into your Messenger list. But let's say that's not really the priority of your business, growing your Messenger list. Instead, maybe you want to capture some sort of customer research, customer insights. For example, in our e-commerce store where we're selling soap and shampoo, maybe we want to ask the user, hey, what's your favorite fragrance? So that in the future, when we're developing new products, we can keep that in mind. So if that's your goal instead, here's how you would do it. you would want to delete the button right here, and then in the text card, you would pose your questions. So what's your favorite fragrance, for example, or what's your email, what's your phone number? Again, delete this button once you ask that question. And then down here for the Save User Input field, if you're asking for the fragrance, for example, you would keep it on text, or if you want to capture the user's email or phone, you would switch this to email or phone. And then you simply want to save whatever their response is to an attribute. So in this case, I could save it to fragrance. I've already created that attribute, so I'll just click that. And we're basically done. Now, all we need to do if we want to send a next message, right, continue the conversation, then we would simply click on this connector down here. So after they respond to this question, after they answer it, we're going to connect them to the next part of the conversation. So that's how to ask a custom question here in the private reply. And again, if you want to go the next step up, you could change this to email or phone. So I'll do email, for example. I would change this attribute to email, and then I would connect whatever email they provide to the next part of the conversation. So that's just another way to use the private reply to your advantage. So is your head spinning? Hopefully not, but just in case it is spinning around like a DVD, then fear not, because I'm gonna recap pretty much everything we just covered. So first, let's start with the public reply. Here, there are really two use cases, and those are automating your FAQs and managing your reputation. With the public reply, you cannot save user input, right? You're just responding to the user's comment. And the media here is just limited to text. Yes, there are some personalization options like customizing the message with the user's first name or their last name, but that is really the extent of it. Next, we have the private reply. And this is ideal for generating leads because you can capture user input like an email, a phone, or a custom question. And obviously here, the media is much more rich and interactive. You can use images, video, and audio, even though I don't really recommend those. But most importantly, you can use buttons and gallery cards. So that's a wrap. If you're ready to start saving time and growing your business on autopilot, then be sure to try Comments Autoreply using the link below in the description. Until next time, happy botting.